Everybody, it's Invicta. It's time for another Eden Run here, the Binding of Isaac Victa Repentance series. We are waiting for another video to cross 5,000 likes before we return the like streak counter down below and getting us ever closer to All Blind Items Week, which I know a lot of people are excited about. I'm starting to actually get a little excited as well because I want to see exactly what kind of crazy runs we're going to be seeing for that entire theme week, and I'm especially looking forward to it. So thank you everyone for those of you who do go back and like those videos, and if you missed this past weekend's videos, definitely check them out. We had a couple of really banger runs, maybe even a surprise run that you may not have seen all the way to the end. It was a lot of fun. So here's your meme of the day. This one brought to you by For Zainter Sempre. Title of the thread was Sinvicta when he took skeleton key and it didn't gave him 99 keys. That's repentance, baby. Now, I don't remember if I already explained it or not, but we determined that it was because I left the room too fast and the keys were not allocated before actually leaving the room. It's the reason why I did not get it. So, yeah. C-Day is going to Quebec, Hotel Lima Mike, Hotel Juliet Victor X-Ray. So you got to be careful whenever you do receive items like that. One would argue that it should just be programmed that no matter if you walk out of the room or not, it should just give it to you and that's just honky-dory. But, eh. So we do have Wait What, which is not Butterbean. This will give us the Butterbean effect, although it does charge a little bit slower than regular Butterbean. However, it does in its compensatory form. Wow, another charge key. We get ourselves the Fissure ability, which is going to do a radial fissure, kind of like this. And that would deal a decent amount of damage to everything around it. And of course, the Butterbean effect is going to give you effectively what is a parry, which is very nice. And I was talking about it on stream over the weekend that, you know, I think that Butterbean, like, low-key is, like, one of the better spacebar items you can have if you're a defensive player or if you think of it like a... I kind of unchecked my built-in installed bias against Butterbean. And I was like, you know what? Let me just think of it like a parry. Like if I think of it as more of a parry, then it becomes more of an appealing item for me to use. And by parrying, I mean like deflecting shots that are coming towards you. That's what I'm talking about when I mean parry. So, and see right there, I was able to use the inner circle of Wait What and actually gain access to the secret room or super secret room in this matter. I'm gonna go back. I know where the secret room is. I just missed it with the inner ring. Right now, we're gonna be fighting Famine. However. He was trying to schmoove on us. Also picked up Tough Love. Tough Love with a 0.55 luck upgrade means that we're probably going to proc it once every like 5 or 6 shots. Not too bad. We are going to also get Ball of Bandages, which gives us an orbital, which doesn't really do much. But I know that the secret room is right here. And it is. And we get Spin Down Die. Oh, baby. Oh, man. And we also get, Mom's Pearl here. So I'm going to use... We're leaving with Spin Down Dive because Spin Down Dive is amazing. I'm going to use Wait What to get this nickel off of the Keeper. I would love to get... We're going to go ahead and take down that. We get Mama Mega as well. I mean, we can only use it in this floor, so there's like no reason to, but... Sure. I mean, who knows? Like, we might find a crawl space, right? Probably not, but, you know, we've already found the secret room and the super secret room. I think it would be unwise for us to go into the curse room, to be honest. Going down to 1 HP is not really conducive with safety. We've got the damage, I suppose. We have the damage to back up our 1 HP start here. I mean, technically, we didn't start 1 HP, you know what I mean. Whoa, baby. Wow, and we get the Pact and Abba Dabba Ding Dong. Okay. I guess we'll just have to take both of these then. Wow. I'm really happy that we went to the curse room. We did not find a crawl space, unfortunately, but that's okay because we found something even way better than that. We got a Badden, and then we also got the freaking Pact for free. That is indeed repentance, baby. Definitely chalk that one up to the side of you should always explore no matter what. All right, well, we still have to be careful because we only have 1.5 soul hearts, so obviously going into the curse room is not exactly ideal. We're still holding on to the spin down die, which I had a brief heart attack over for a second because I thought that I'd forgotten it. I was like, oh man, we were really not going to hear the end of this. So yeah, that's one heck of a good start here. 7.34 damage, 4.27 tier delay. What more? And we also start with spin down die. Forget about it. Spin down die, by the way, if you don't know what it does, it will lower the item ID, not the level, but the item ID by one. So as you can see on the external information mod right there, like just for example, spin down die turns into Anima Solo, which turns into TM Trainer, which turns into Jar of Everything. That's assuming that we had another spin down die on a pedestal, but effectively it's spin down die gives you so many more options that it's like ridiculous per item pedestal, because the item IDs are not tied to the rarity of the item. Like Botfly turns into like, you know, death certificate. So like, you know, we're going to have to, I don't know, take death certificate real quick. Wow. This start is one of the best starts I have ever seen in Repentance. Sounds like a total like clickbait like title, but like it's freaking true, dude. This is insane. So I think you know where we're going with this, just because we've got the fire rate, we've got the already damage. Already built-in damage, should say, but I don't know. Maybe we're not gonna quite go to Sacred Heart yet. I definitely, after that last episode that we had with Death Certificate, I am subscribing to the belief that I don't think Rock Bottom is. I don't think that Rock Bottom is the automatic play anymore, and I beat that point like over and over again into the commentary for that episode. And I'm not going to go over it again, but basically the short and skinny of it is the fact that I think that honestly, Rock Bottom is only as good as the items that you put into it. And if you start with Rock Bottom and then don't get any items that really benefit you, like, you know, that have a negative side, like say Soy Milk or something like that, or Kidney Stone, then you're really not getting a whole lot for Rock Bottom for like an entire death certificate's worth, and that's problematic. So starting with Sacred Heart, it gives us an absolutely massive amount of damage. We get homing tears, you know. Yes, our shot speed's horrible, but I mean, who cares about shot speed at a time like this, especially when we already have spin down die, which is just going to allow us to continue to roll and roll and roll. We get more items. We just get, like, you know, death certificate from Botfly. And that's kind of what I was talking about leading into that item room, is that, like, you can just get some of the best items from some of the worst items. We'll take a range up. We already know what's inside of here. Actually, no, we don't. Just kidding. Don't think we can take either one of these. But truth be told, I also don't remember how much... I don't remember how much HP we have. I'm gonna hit escape so we're not wasting the clock for a moment. Sacred Heart gives you an HP upgrade. We came to this floor with 1.5 soul hearts. We picked up another soul heart, which leaves us at 2.5. If I take Death's Touch, we will be at 1.5 heart, 1.5 heart HP. Or maybe we're at 1 HP. I'm not sure. I don't. Does Sacred Heart give you more than 1 HP? No, it does. It gives you 1. So we now should be able to get into... We're not at a half heart because Isaac would be peeing on the floor. But... Excuse me? We're not even at 1 HP? So we must be at 1.5 HP then. So somewhere along the line, I must have picked up a soul heart and not paid attention. Did I buy it in here? I may have bought it in here. But, I mean, just what can you say about the start? Like, seriously, this is going in the record books. Curse of the Unknown again. I mean, I'm not fully caring about what our HP is currently. I would like to believe that we've got like a good amount of HP, but I'm pretty sure that we're at 1.5. See, now that's what we can't have happen. It's just mega troll bombs just coming at us. Because then I'm not so sure anymore. I know that we're over one HP. That's all I care about. I mean, come on. Death Touch, Sacred Heart, Pact, Abaddon, Spin Down Die. If this ain't a one run, I don't know what is, brother. I don't know what it is, sister. That's gotta get a few extra likes on that one, because good lord. This is the Isaac start that everyone dreams of. And we're only just getting started here. We're about to have some fun, y'all. I saw that game. I'm be very cautious here, even though I know that we have more than enough HP to just win right now. Eden's Blessing, which is a tiers upgrade, which turns into pay to play, which turns into Pupula Duplex. I mean, Eden's Blessing is a tiers up. I'm willing just to take it, which means that we are going to have an extra item on tomorrow's run. Car battery, we do not want. We do not want with Spin Down Die. No, 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 no. We go back up to 16 cents. So, but what we are looking for is something like the battery, something like Charge Baby, which we've already seen. Anything that can give us more and more uses per floor is great. Ah, man, you just look at this damage, and it's just like it's almost unfair. Like fallen, forget about it. Absolutely forget about it. Yeah, Ocular Rift. I mean, no. You're still not cool enough. Bump us up now to a 73% Devil Deal chance that we can finally see how much HP we have. And some of the Mosh Pit detectives, you're going to have to go back and tell me whether or not we... wait, if we get... Will this give us two items tomorrow? I have to know. I don't think I've ever been put in the situation before where we can get two Eden's Blessings in one run. In one floor of each other. I have a feeling that it probably will give us two items, but I don't want to assume anything. The more HP we get, the more money that we can get to find out. I'm gonna leave it up to the Mosh Pit observers and the Mosh Pit detectives to see if whether or not I was correct about how much HP we had. And if I wasn't during those Curse of the Unknowns, then please let me know where the HP came from. That's your homework. That's your new homework for the day. All right, my job here is to try to figure out if we're gonna get double Eden's Blessing. Your job is to figure out if I was right or how off I was about how much HP we had during the Curse of the Unknowns. All right, good. Shake on it. Ready, break. All right. Love to get some flying here. Movement speed also would not be. I ain't gonna hate on it. Shot speed, you know. Sacred Heart. That is one of the very, 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 very few downsides of Sacred Heart. Is the fact that it does kill your shot speed. go ahead and take breakfast here, and we get D-Bizzle. Ooh, man. Now, I'm actually against Cricket's body at this point. Because you can't see anything, and also, like, our range is also already kind of doo-doo also. So, also, I'm not going to be taking that, and I'll be also taking Gimpy also. Yeah, because, I mean, technically our range is not doo-doo, but it looks bad because of how bad our shot speed is. We are not leaving until we get Eden's Blessing, and also we still haven't found the item room yet. Just want to point that out. Crack the Skizzle. We also get Mystery Gift, but we can't use Spin Down Die right now because, wow, man, Mom's Pearl is just crushing it for us. We can't use Spin Down Die because we're trying to get Eden's Blessing from Friend Ball. And we are not leaving until we get that Friend Ball and turn it into Eden's Blessing. This is happening, game. So how long it takes us to get there is up to you, but this is happening one way or another. I thought. Then we get Binky. Binky actually would give us a nice tears up as well. But now we can combine that here with Eden's Blessing. And two away from Arky. But Binky actually capped us, so it's all right. Now we just need some shot speed. If we can get some shot speed, oh baby. We are effectively completely canceling out any of the very, 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 very few downsides. Sacred Heart. Just effectively is just one, and that's just the fact that you just have doo-doo for shot speed. Even the tears down doesn't, I mean, it's freaking Sacred Heart. We got a lot of catching up to do here to get back on pace for Boss Rush, and let's do it. E-Bizzle, number one. Not convinced. I am. All right, Spin Down Die perfectly synced up, ready to go for this item room here. I mean, Mom's Perfume, it does break the tears cap. Luckfoot, you know, Luckfoot's Luckfoot. It gives you a neutral to positive pills, which is, you know, fine. Andor's Bizox. We could get another Mama Mega, but I don't really think we need to. Waiting on D-Bizzle. Shout out again to Spin Down Die just for being an absolute chad of an item. You know, as soon as we acquired it, like I said, the insane amount of options that you get and the insane amount of value that you get, it really does put Spin Down Die in the discussion for what is the best space bar item you can get. You know, and there's a lot of those. There really is a lot of those. But Spin Down Die is just so, so good. It can make bad items into incredible items. And those are my favorite type of items. Little Gish is going to turn to the relic, which is way better than Little Gish. We got Binge Eater, which is a gut. I mean, we could take We could take Guppy's eye. We can only take one of these. Or we take Binge Eater. And Binge Eater with this build would be just stupid. I'm gonna take Incubus for sure. I know there's a lot of people that don't like Binge Eater. I'm gonna take it though, because I wanna see what it can do for us with Spin Down Die. And I guess Little Gish you can come to. I want to see if it's possible to take Binge Eater and combine it with Spin Down Die and actually get, like, you know, a real build going. Besides just, like, HP. Also, I don't know why that one missed. We get the quarter. So it does turn into the Holy Relic. It turns into Rosary. That's interesting. That's very interesting. Because assuming that you can get multiple item pedestals to appear, that is a lot of tiers real fast. Oh, hey, look, we got another use of Spin Down Die. Nice. Now, obviously, we wanted to take Binge Eater for now because we just want to get out of the danger zone. Not that we're in, like, that much trouble, but, you know. Binge Eater is going to also give us a temporary stat boost and a permanent stat boost every time we take a Binge Eater item, which is effectively just an HP upgrade, but you get so much more out of it. I mean, we all know my love for Binge Eater. I mean, it's like, is this just going to be a smorgasbord of, like, just the best and my most favorite items ever? Because it's definitely starting to feel like it right now. Yeah, well, we have no way of getting out of the mom fight real quick, so we need to go find our teleportation out of here. Finding that tinted skull would be great. This is also some kind of Isaac Circle, let me tell you what. Ebizzle. And we went through great lengths to get to just catch up on the timer here, and of course with us not seeing a single sign of the shop or the item room, that means that they are adjacent from one another. As an ingrained, enshrined fact in the world of Isaac. I can tell this is a blue mom, okay. That was red mom for a second. I am going to, of course, take the negative. I say of course because this run is so damn powerful. That turns into synth oil. I mean, I really want to take it. I'm going to take a snack, though, because I want to see if we can get more options here inside of Proptosis. Turns into Black Candle. Proptosis turns into Black Candle. That turns into Blood of the Martyr. That turns into Abyss, and that turns into Compass. Proptosis, though, man, that's a ton of damage. I can't pass up a ton of damage. I mean, like, Black Candle is Black Candida, but listen, Proptosis gives us an absolute... we already have, like, what would be a metric butt ton of damage, but this turns it into, like, an imperial butt ton of damage. There's someone laughing out there really, really hard right now. I wouldn't mind getting the compass, to be honest. I mean, like, the mulligan is the mulligan, but, like, honestly? Wait a second. I thought I saw... You showed me the compass. What is this? I'll take the shot speeding. I feel like we've been scammed, D Bizzle. Been straight up scammed. We can bomb the reroll machine here. Get a lucky penny. There are no more item pedestals that I know of. This is one in the curse room. Like, obviously I would have wanted to take the mulligan there, but I thought I was getting the compass. Guppy's head. It makes me a little bit sad that we didn't take Guppy's eye, but you know why I didn't do that. And yeah, we're just gonna head on Dizown, but man oh man. This is a run for... Now this is a way to start off a week, I tell you what. That is a ton of damage there. And remember, we're going to be dealing amplified damage because of Binge Eater's temporary buff. And also remember, we've got the Sacred Heart damage buff as well. So we've just got a whole mess of damage. Thank you, D-Bizzle. Very happy that we at least got Speedball. Now, of course, one of the downsides to Binge Eater now, after it's been nerfed, is the fact that you do have to worry about the speed down that comes with taking so many HP ups after you have Binge Eater. So for us to have, like, you know, 1.45 movement speed with Binge Eater is kind of a dream right now. That dream can quickly go away if we take too many Binge Eater items, which I'm not planning on doing. Because, I mean, you know, we want to have fun with spin down die. But I am very interested in making the Rosary work. Because that's a significant amount of HP, and on top of that, it's a good tears up as well. Be honest, I would not have been interested in that Ancient Recall, which is the reason why I'm just skipping over it. There's no reason for us not to, of course, but I want to go smash some bosses. Now, with us having Spin Down Die, it also does highly increase the chance that we can get ourselves an R key and maybe get ourselves an Omega Run. We haven't seen one in a little while. At the time of us using Death Certificate on the floor number 2 or whatever that was, we were ill-prepared for an Omega Run. But now we're getting to the point where, like, you know, we got to start thinking about it, y'all. That turns into Skipping Stone, which I do not want. I will take the Binge Eater buff. And Goathead. You know, I wouldn't mind Goathead here. Ouija board turns into Mom's Knife. That turns to Abyss. Yeah, we can take Ouija board. Spectral Tears, I'm down with. Isaac's side profile was me, like, reading YouTube comments sometimes. Not my own, of course. I'm talking about, like, on other people's channels. It's a shocked awe. Or, like, me whenever, like, you know, it takes us, like, 35 cents for a claw machine to pay out. The face that I make sitting here. I don't know why that expression's so funny. I think it's because it looks like it's like a little chibi head. There you go, D-Bizzle. That's what I'm talking about. We got ourselves another Isaac Circle. But hey, at least we can shoot through those rocks. Got a golden key. No reason for us to not go in here. Latchkey actually becomes a blue cap, which would actually give us a huge, like a bigger, like shot speed down. So I'm actually not going to take it now that I think about it. Eternal Heart here. D-Bizzle, I got you. Don't you worry. Lover's Card, it does give us a secret room option here. If we can find the secret room, and I'll give you one good guess of where it is. World's most obvious secret room. Lover's Card, yeah. Well, you know, I mean, Synth Oil is not bad. We needed the range for sure, and that's going to help us out with Proptosis, our newly acquired shot speed, which I think actually Binge Eater usually gives out a lot of. So, you know, Binge Eater is not necessarily a horrible pickup either for us in regards to trying to counter our bad shot speed. But would have been happier with something, anything other than the Book of Freaking Secrets. Yeah. Yeah. Spin down die on Vengeful Spirit turns into Isaac's Tomb, which is not a bad item, actually. Now, what happens if we roll... What happens if we spin down the breakfast? Will we get a different Devil Deal item? Very confused. My guess is because whenever you use spin down die, it makes that item pedestal into the primary item pedestal. And then Binge Eater, of course, takes over and says, no, wait, but you can have this one instead. We get Guppy's collar, so we would have gotten Guppy had I actually taken Guppy's eye instead of Incubus. I mean, come on, like who's gonna actually take that though? And it made sense. Hindsight's always 20/20, you know, you can't use it against yourself. It's unfair. You'll never be able to compete against hindsight, ever. So just don't try. But I tell people all the time, don't try to live by someone else's rules. Like if you try to compare yourself to someone else, you're already being unfair to yourself. You're setting the bar by someone else's standards, and you'll never be able to reach them. Don't do that. Just like in weightlifting, or let's take weightlifting for example. Like you're never gonna be as strong as like Arnold in his prime, or at least most likely not anyway. I mean, I don't know exactly how strong you are, but let's hypothetically say, I mean, you can't compare yourself to what Arnold was doing at your age or like your height or your weight or whatever like that. You know, it's unfair. You're going off of Arnold standards. You need to go off of you standards. And I know it's easier said than done, but don't make life unfair on yourself. Life is already unfair for a lot of people. Don't make it harder on yourself by trying to go by someone else's standards. Wow. That was one dead Stanley. In like a heartbeat dead. In like, it didn't even have a chance to spawn anything dead. So I have a good chance for Guppy here. Less enthused about Damocles. I think what we do... Damocles is tempting though. But... I think it's not worth it. We can get 9 lives by way of Lord of the Pit. That's how we do it. I'm gonna take Blanket. So we can get Guppy. Now I wish I would have taken Damocles because I didn't know that we were gonna be able to get 9 lives here. That would be the way to end it, though. That would be a very unceremonious end to our runs if we decided that, we're good enough. We don't have to worry about Damocles. No. Damocles killing us and then Guppy's collar not procking. All right, D-Bizzle, you just got a whole wealth. You're binge eating yourself here, so we better see some soul hearts here, son. That's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about. E-Bizzle. Good to see you back in full form here, son. Not a single spider in this room. Look at that. Judgment. No! Saved your life, Judgment. I mean, I ain't gonna complain about Deadeye. I'm willing to do a full clear if that means we can get Deadeye, but I mean, that's... unlikely considering that we're about to have to use this for 9 lives here. We get 9 lives, which is going to give us Guppy. And I mean, the run that just keeps getting more and more stronger. Yeah, when you can kill blorbs before they can fire, you're in for a fun time. When you can kill the shades before they can attack, you're in for a good time. So we have a chance. It's a small chance, but we do have a chance of getting Deadeye here, which would really, really amp up the pain on the game. I'm all for. Like, 100% all for. Ghost Hat, and then goes into Holy Light, and then it goes into Deadeye, which is exactly what we want. Now, whether or not we're going to be able to... be mad if we see 9 lives, okay. Whether or not we actually get there, you know, it's gonna be a challenge unless we. I mean, sharp plug would also not be too bad. We get a charge key. Oh my god! Now I'm looking around. I'm like, who do I have to pay here for this run? Who am I owing money to for this run, game? Well, a charge key will definitely do it. Go back and get Deadeye here. The Holy Light came from Host Hat, and then we just go take this. And we go skirt. Watch us miss it. We just missed Deadeye. Yeah, Deadeye is... I mean, what can you say about this run? It was an absolutely, from start to finish, incredible run. And we just getting started, y'all. Second run. Alpha Lima Quebec, Victor, Romeo Delta, Charlie 8. All right. Tech Zero might actually crash the game. I'm gonna do it, but under advisement of it may crash the game and I may have to remove it with the developer console. Tech 1 as well, but Tech 1 does destroy Deadeye. Get our Spun Transformation, 65.96 damage is pretty good. No! I was reading. That's what I get. Cursed Eye turns into Holy Mantida. But I don't think we're going to have enough... I'm pretty sure we're not going to have any full charges here. We get a reroll machine, which we do not. And we're off to the races. Now, I know what you're saying. You're saying it's Invicta. How can we not go into alt path? Well, I want to try to find an R key if possible. Which means that we either need Botfly or whatever the item that is before Botfly. And we have a really good shot at getting it because we have Spin Down Die. Spin Down Die gives us the best shot outside of actually just finding Death Certificate. That turns into Sausage, eh? I want Compass too, though. Yeah, but it's Sausage. Come on now. Doesn't really turn into much here. Empty Vessel turns into Thame. Turns into Revelation. We can come back in here, but I don't think that we're going to have enough. We would need 2 full charges in order for us to get a Revelation. But do we really even need Revelation? I feel like we don't. I feel like charging up for Revelation is just going to make it like... it's just going to make, like, the room, like, last longer. Pyromaniac brother.
Sure.
We'll take the explosive immunity and also 5 bombs. Okie dokie. So we're not going to be able to find another full charge here, unfortunately. That's okay. We can still take... What was this? This was... Rapicamide. We could take Empty Vessel. I mean... Empty Vessel to... We might as well take the Binge Eater buff just because it's right there. And Tropicamide, we'll take some range. Feels like kind of a crime not to use Spin Down Die, but opportunity was not there. So again, that stacking damage buff that you're seeing there is a result of the decay from Binge Eater. Oh, we're just getting a Planetary, and they're just giving us everything. Mars turns into Luna, which, I mean... Getting the stairway also ain't bad. Stairway allows us to, again, have a chance for a death certificate or Genesis. So one more and that gets us to the stairway. Global D-Twanky. Just kind of hoping that we was going to roll into... Oh, it did roll into a charge key. Yo, okay. I'm going to leave that there for now. That way, if we need another reroll, we can get it. It's death list, and then the only item I saw there that caught my eye was a lead pencil. We're bouncing here because we have explosion immunity, so it doesn't matter. We do not have shot immunity though. Okay, so let's go get the stairway here since we already have our full charge. No reason to keep clearing stuff to waste it. Stairway. I'm not going to screw that one up. I did with Tech Zero. Honestly, it's probably better that we didn't have Tech Zero, though, just because of its penchant to, like, you know, or tendency, I should say, to crash the game. You've got high damage and high tiers. Soul Converter. I mean, I really... Again, I really freaking want... I want the compass. I want mapping. All right, before I buy that full charge, let's see what else we can find in terms of item pedestals here. And see if we can make the R key possible. Okay. Blood clot. There's our compass. Some Victor robes. D-Bizzle. I think we take Sin robes here. And I want my compass. Yeah. And then let's go back. With the full charge in the shop, I still don't think that's enough, even with that charge key there as well. For us to get the lead pencil. Gotta see what else this turned into. Himalacria. Lacrivergy ain't a bad idea. I mean, Dogtooth is a slight damage up, but like we're better off just taking Binge Eater at this point here. No, wait, stop. We don't want to use money. Remember, we have the stairway. Gotta remember that. Appreciate the pill, D-Bizzle, but you're not needing it right now. All right, stairway, show us what we want to see. Yeah, that's just... It's just a shame. I guess we'll take the key piece. That was Guppy's paw. I don't remember what it turns into. But you got to be careful. That is one of the downsides of Binge Eater, is the fact that, like, is you do have to be careful when it comes to item pedestal, because it will change instantly. So take your time when walking into pedestals. So some Torium turns into Let Me Get Down, and then Little Brimstone turns into Lost Fly, which none of these trees excite me. So the damage up. Here's range up. Take range. Again, not really helping us out a little bit. Not that we need help, of course, but I'm looking for items that we've not already seen, you know. Mystery gift. A mystery gift has a chance to turn into something that we want. So I think we should try it anyway. We have multiple full charges, I think. Yeah, we've got a couple full charges here, so. Turn into Binge Eater. I don't know what Binge Eater turns into. Remember when I was talking about how we didn't want to see items that we've already taken? Game? Remember that? I do. Pepperidge Farm remembers. Turns into Quince, which turns into... I mean... I'm okay with taking... Quince. I'm also, like, not really... I'm not hating the idea of taking card reading either. Let's go see the boss. Let's see what we get here. I actually probably shouldn't have used those rerolls until after seeing the boss, because we may have needed those for the Omega run. Sacred Orb and Glitch Crown. A Sacred Orb is something that is worth getting over whatever we were considering in the secret room. I've already forgotten. Mom's Pearls gives us a range and luck upgrade. And the Mom Transformation, kind of whatever. We can clear. I know we have a full charge inside of the store, but I'm going to clear anyway. Really hoping that we're going to see Nun's Habit inside of the... inside of the stairway. But Sacred Orb is a pretty big part in us getting higher quality items, which means that we have a higher chance of getting an R key, because it removes the lower quality items out of the pool. We say goodbye to Sanguine Bond and hello to Sacred Orb. And this is it's an ample time to test to see what it can do with Stairway as well. We'll take the Mind. I know it turns into Godhead, but we don't have the charges for it. Taking Key Piece as a go. Now we need to beat Boss Rush and Hush on this run, and then head to, we gotta head to, Megastan and then Delirium after Blue Baby and Isaac. And that will determine whether or not we even have a chance of even going for the Omega run. Because obviously if we get teleported out of the Delirium fight, or if we can't get to the Delirium fight, I should say, then it doesn't matter. And, you know, it's Mega Satan ends the run, and then that's that. You can't say we didn't try, though. Jacob's... Oh, my God. Jacob's Ladder instead of Ghost Pepper is much spicier than you may think. really hoping that we find Nun's Habit, because that would make our life with Fin Dun Dai a lot easier. Finding so many items inside of these chests here. Yeah, we do not want car battery. Again, car battery is good for certain situations, but never, in my opinion, never is it ever worth it whenever you have a reroll. Excuse me? Thank you. Yeah, but Isaac. Okay. Remember when we took Sacred Heart and we just had, like, absolutely no shot speed? Boy, those were the days, weren't it? Cat of Nine Tails, I'll take just for the shot speed at this point. Oh, man. Yeah, Fat Out of Mushroom. None of these are really tickling my fancy. Maybe we could take Lord of the Pit for, like, movement speed, I guess. But we can Leviathan anyway. Fat on Mushroom. And, sure, Anemic. You can come, too. And I would love to take... I'd really love to take, Star of Bethlehem. Not that we need it again, of course, but why be strong when you can be stronger? I'm gonna take Luckfoot, I guess. Sun card, sure, why not? The sun. That's a long way to go for boss rush. Not that we have any danger of missing out on it, but a long way to go. Luckfoot is gonna give us a neutral or positive pill effect, just like PhD, except they don't come with they don't come identified. I'm going to take Toxic Shock here. Help speed up our clear time a little bit. Not that we needed help of it, of course, but our base damage is so high that it's just going to absolutely wreck things, all right? Like, we're not even going to have to fire anything. I mean, our base damage is 91.23. I think we're gonna be all right. And no, we don't need that. We do need the money though. But we'll take the money. Megamush turns into. There is a Genesis. Ooh. Do we really want to give up this run, though? The thing is, if we take Genesis, then we are completely at the mercy of seeing Arky, which we have not yet. And all of it, again, is kind of moot if we don't get past the Mega Satan wall anyway, so... Bad PH Dizzle. Tears up, or tears down, damage up. It doesn't matter. Let's see here. Libra, Sad Bombs, Synth Oil, Growth Hormone, Chocolate Milk. I think Rubber Cement's fine. Continuum wouldn't have been bad, except like we don't need the range. And it's fun to watch, like, Deadeye tears just fly all over the place. Eden Soul, that's a reroll. My God. Now remember, the enemies at the end of the other side of the screen, they're getting the tail end of Proptosis damage, which means that they're getting exponentially less damage than we are like putting out, and we're still destroying them. Rosary. No charge keys anywhere. Nope. Well, I tried. I'll take the rosary just because. Seraphim, sure. Stars card, hey. All right, so boss rush down. Now we got to make our way to Old Hushy. Old Hushy. I mean, holy light, like, I'm all over. So at this point, what we have to hope for is we gotta hope for us getting our key. What on earth just happened there? We gotta hope for us getting our key, and also us, like, you know, going past the Megastan wall. Because if we get to Void, there's still a chance that we can get an R key down there as well. Again, the chance is always gonna be there with us having spin down die. It's always going to be there. We don't have to shoot anything. Of course they spawn enemies. Contract from below turns into experimental treatment, which we don't need or want. Zazel's Rage turns into Twisted Pear, which, I mean, sure, we'll take. Get the conjoined transformation, which means we're just going to have more visual doo-doo going all over the place. And even though they're going to be dealing a percentage of our damage, like, they're still going to be, like, killing it. Seraphim anyway here on Curse the Blind. Pretty much makes our job easy. Yeah. Yeah, that's quite a bit of damage right there, I tell you what. We can't take that because we don't know what it is, because it's Curse the Blind. But Old Hushy. Old Hushy is about to be Old Saddy. Capricorn. Okay. Bloody Gust. No, nothing going on in there. Also, I realized that we screwed up the, there's Diplopia. I realized that we screwed up, the stairway. So we can get double Capricorn here, which will break the tears cap, by the way. There we go. Got a lucky penny for our thoughts. I should probably go back and actually get that money real quick. Wow. Have you ever seen Hush get chunked down like that? Good Lord. That is an absolute butt whooping. Chrysaggian would literally end this run. By end it, I mean like crash it. We're gonna take Revelation here. Take a look at the secret room here. Hilarious game. Only got a charge key, and that's okay. So, the hope now lies within our ability. I wouldn't mind Lump of Coal, actually. Our ability to get a lot of charges with the spin down die, and hopefully we can see our key here. But again, we still have to pass the Mega Satan block regardless of this. Whether we had an R key or not, we still gotta go past it. Health down, Ipecac tier, shot speed up.
Shot speed.
All right, let's see if we can get it. Stigmata turns to number one. Blood of the Martyr, I mean. D-Fizzle.
Bye-bye.
Okay. Red key. Eden Soul. Now, Eden Soul might not be worth... It might not be a bad idea to try to get that. It also has the D in... The D... Infinity. I was looking at something else. I'm trying to also think about, like, how to speak... Or it could just give us the R key. Oh, boy. Now, this is the most blessed run of all time. If we can get past the Mega Satan door. And get a delirium port, and like it gives us delirium. Wow. But then we're dependent on getting another R key, or us getting a sacrifice room inside of Corpse 2 for Mother. Did get a delirium portal. I was going to say, going after Eden Soul would not be a bad idea. I didn't actually mean to go in here. It wouldn't actually be a bad idea because we had a chance to get our key, like if I just brought it to the secret room, but it just gave us our key, so. All right, well, moment of truth here. Can we do it? We might as well take all these. I mean, we do have other full charges for spin down die. Let's look real quick. Is there a good spin down die option? I mean, we can still get Eden's soul. At this point, I don't know what in the world we would use it for in the secret room. I mean, theoretically, we could get rock bottom. How crazy would it be if we got, like, backpack and another R key out of this? Why do I keep going this way? Stop doing that, brain. Yeah, I know it's late and all, but, like, you know. Stop. Actually, no, we would need to charge it. We need to charge Eden's soul But even then... Oh, God. Okay. All right. Oh, there's the lead pencil that I wanted. What I'm trying to say is that even if we use Eden's Soul inside the secret room, we can't spin it down because of the presence of our key. We would lose it. So whatever we get here, I mean, unless if it's death certificate, like, not going to really matter. But just for funsies, let's see what we get. Yeah. Urchomycosis is fine by me. Golden teleporter, meh. We're just getting so many chests. We don't even have Guppy's tail. Wow, we even get Spoonbender. I mean, this run really is like just everyone's like favorite run that you could dream up. All we need now is Sissy. The D1 Hizzle. That would be slap to the face of everybody. Don't think we take it. We could take Chaos, I guess, but I think Chaos is not going to be needed. Give me the buff. Let's get this over with. We say thank you once and for all. The spin down die will never forget what you've done for us. Get ready for the fastest Mega Satan kill you've probably ever seen. Yeah. Instant death. And we do get a Delirium Portal. All right, it's on. Oh man, if your hearts aren't pumping now, I don't know what to tell you. We'll take Sensor. It is on. Now people have been telling me that I need to be looking at the layout of Delirium, of Void. You can actually see which one it is based on the width of the room. I've had a venture guess it's the one all the way to the east. The one that's like all the way out of the way. Does it look slightly different? Just a guess. I'm applying my own logic and sense in here. Oh, I know. Stand back, everyone. Look at the shot speed. And I'd be incorrect. I'm not going to take Dirty Mind because it's just going to be just more... Like, we don't need items at this point. There we go. Down goes Delirium. Same seed, same everything. I mean, Genesis is another way to get an Omega run because you can get R key from it, essentially. I don't know what to say at this point. Other than wow. I'm gonna take the fragmented card. Remember, we have we've got the mine, so we're gonna be able to find out where those extra secret rooms are. Okay, so we've done every boss except for Mother and Beast now. So all we gotta do is get a sacrifice room in Corpse 2. We're gonna have to hold on to Genesis all the way to Corpse 2, just in case we don't find an R key beforehand. So now we go to Corpse. Well, not yet. You know what I mean. There's no reason for us to go into the stairway right now. We've already got Genesis, and even if there was something in there, we wouldn't be able to afford it anyway. Cricket Smelter, I mean, it's not a bad pickup for 7 cents. Oh my god. Oh boy. This is almost starting to feel like wrong. You know what I mean? Like this is starting to feel dirty. In all the right ways. I'm gonna take synth oil. Binge eater. And a binge eater. Like we're not stopping for anything here. I would love to get salvation, but we don't need the keys because we've already fought Mega Satan and we've already beaten Delirium, so it's just down to Mother and Beastie. That's it. Old Beastie. So what we're looking for here, essentially, what we're looking for is going to be R key or death certificate. If we get a chance to take spin down die in Genesis, that's something else that we could do. Oh my god. I don't know what these are gonna look like. And at this point, we're just taking more items so we can roll through more things when we come to, Genesis. So there's the mirror. Let's go get the knife piece. We can find our fire. There it is. Oh yeah. We can get Salvation, we can get Star of Bethlehem too. I mean, we're not going to need Star of Bethlehem. I'm gonna take Salvation. Okay. Take the knife piece. We're not gonna worry about fighting the boss. I'd rather get out of the flipped world just because I don't want to accidentally die in there or blow up the mirror. That is the only way that we would actually die. Take blue cap, we get the fungi transformation. Guppy's collar. Hey, redundancy, right? All right. So we have a sacrifice room here, but obviously we're still nowhere near the floor that we actually need it on. Very strange to see one secret room into a sacrifice room into a secret room. There we go. We got a temperance machine. Okay, all right. If we need the money for the stairway, then we can get it if we have to. We got plenty of HP. was hoping for, just get a little bit more money so we have more forgiveness if we end up finding something that we need inside of the ladder, which, again, with Genesis, that's the last thing that we actually wanted. Now, that's not to say that we wouldn't take Godhead, of course, but, you know, let's be real. We're doing okay here. Now, if we can get Backpack, that gives me even more hope for an Omega run here. Not Backpack, but we can take more options. As a quick reminder, everyone, if you're enjoying this episode here, and I don't understand how you wouldn't be able to, but if you are, make sure you click the like button. I would appreciate it. Helps out the channel a great deal. Actually, I was trying to get Benji to do there. Too busy talking, too busy gabbing, too busy telling people to hit that like button. Let's see this video get to over 5,000 likes so we can get back on course for the blind items taken week. All blind items week is going to be just insane, man. Okay, these are the only bosses that we can't actually do anything about. And it might actually crash the game. We have to hope that we can hit it with a bomb, because our tier effects are just going to keep proccing. There we go. Okay. Like, Trisagion makes, like, against Tough Twins, like, actually makes, like, it makes you crash, like, straight up. Because your tier effects just keep firing nonstop. Trisagion plus, like, sinus infection, that sort of thing, it screws up the game, like, royally. I don't need Scapular. I'd rather hold on to the money. And I'm going to hold on to the Temperance Machine here. Serpent's Kiss. Not that we'll ever utilize it, but you never know. All right, we're looking for Backpack. Take Champion Belt here just because. Might as well take some more damage. Went ahead, get more ahead. This is exactly what we're doing right now. This is not the room I was expecting. I was expecting this room. All right, so we got to go through the mines here for the alt path. And just look at our base damage. Even our base stats are just so good. This run, I mean, again, top to bottom, this run was an absolute banger. It's the type of run that you just dream of. Now, it can be the ultimate dream run if and only if we get a sacrifice room in Corpse 2 and we can make the Omega run happen. That would be the ultimate run. Send off Mom into the distance here. That's her sneaky off-screen charge there, which is kind of BS, to be honest, but... Darn, I was trying to make it over there. Make our life a little bit easier on the way... back this side. You know, and I give Repentance a lot of grief, but I gotta say that during the Mother run, the Indiana Jones part that we're in right here, like, it's intelligently programmed to make sure that it's got like the most anti-you path whenever you're trying to run through it that like it can be. Like, you know, you get the eternal flies, you get like the strategical buttons, the spikes. Just hoping that Jacob's Ladder doesn't crash the game here. It's gonna crash. I'm almost guaranteeing it. Surprisingly didn't crash. I can't believe it. I can't really see what that is, so I'm just gonna leave. Yeah, I mean, we can take Incubus and Succubus and... Yeah, we can take Glass Eye as well. Why not? Oh, why not? Grab our half heart because we're desperately in need of HP. We got the knife pieces. We've got everything. We got Genesis to fall back on. As our ultimate, like, you know, save us from losing out on the Omega Run. But what I'm really hoping for is we just get another R key, or we get crawl space here, or we get death certificate. Oh wow, tech point five is tech point five just makes this. I mean, this run was already stupid, but it's like it's getting even stupider. Oh my god. You know, just 87 damage up. That's fine. Pretty good. Keeper sack as well. I mean, sure, at this point, why not? How big are these babies gonna be? They're pretty big. 500 damage. It's okay. Babies, I'm gonna need you to stop. I'm gonna need you to stop moving my bombs. It's not cool, man. Yeah. Get rid of this broken heart real quick. Stapler, it's just damage on damage on damage at this point. Guppy's tail, I mean, hell, why not? Two of clubs doubles our bombs. Let's see if we can get something that we really, really, really want in the stairway. That is not it. I mean, at this point, supper sounds good. Oh no, we lost perfection. Shoot the whoop. I mean, shoot the whoop. Like I ain't mad at you, shoot, but can't take it. Your services are not needed on this run here, brother. Black candle, why not? At this point, why not? So we don't have to worry about Curse the XL or anything, or Curse the Blind kind of ruining our fun, you know. So we're not going to get a chance to do boss rush again, unfortunately. Which I think is not that big of a deal when it comes down to it. Something tells me that we're not going to need boss rush. I am going to take Brimstone. Because I want to. Now, whether or not we're going to get a chance to fire Brimstone is a totally different thing. Yeah, that's, as we have summoned a sun. We are literally Escanor now. My dream come true. All right. We're one level away from seeing it happen. Can we or can we not get a sacrifice room in Corpse 2? If we can get a sacrifice room on the next level, what am I doing? If we can get a sacrifice room in the next level, we will be able to complete the Omega run. If we don't, then it comes down to Genesis. Are you sure you want to live through that? Yeah. I'll just save you all the... spare you the visuals there. I'm going to take divorce papers, not for the tears up, but just to make sure that we have, like, you know, items to roll through. I will take death's list as well, not that we'll ever utilize it. And now's the moment of truth. Will we get a sacrifice room? Cross your fingers, cross your toeses, cross your little sissies, and everything else. Come on, game. We did get a sacrifice room! Let's go! Oh, baby. It is indeed the ultimate dream of a run. The Omega run is upon us. Oh, man. Okay, so we're going to do what I didn't do the last time we were in the situation, which was play the sacrifice room until we're ready to get teleported to the lamb, and then go fight Mother, and then kill ourselves to get out of the room so we can come back here. But we're going to be smart about it this time. We're going to leave HP on the ground as well. Gimpy's just going to pay out. We don't even need Genesis anymore. There we go. And there it is. All we gotta do now is fight Mother, destroy ourselves, and come back. And the ultimate Omega run is complete. And you thought it was just gonna be a regular run-of-the-mill Tuesday. Oh boy. Oh boy. So don't blink because you might miss Mother. Hey, we got Deathless payout. Cool. So now all we got to do is get to the sacrifice room, tap it, beat Lamb, and it is done. It's on our way to Beastie to call it call it a day. And if you're not clicking the like button on this one, I don't know what you're doing with yourself. Yes, we... we have to get rid of Pyro. We can't kill ourselves because of Pyro. Well, it's a good thing we have Genesis. All right, so now we have to build strategically here. You may want to fast forward this if you're watching this still, because this is gonna take a while, y'all. But we have to be strategic here, because not only do we need 9 lives, we need a way to resurrect, but we also need to be able to beat Beast now. This was the only way that we could have gotten out of there, because Pyro stopped us from actually killing ourselves. So we're gonna be here for a while. Just go ahead and fast forward this. I'll let you get on with yourself. I'm gonna take Mom's knife for security here. Sure, Guppy's paw. Give me Maw of the Void. We haven't seen Maw of the Void today. Blue map. Trust me, we're gonna be a while because we had so many dang items that I have no doubt that we're gonna be able to get back to we're not gonna be as powerful as we were, but we're still gonna be pretty dang powerful. I'll take compass, I guess, just for navigation. We'll take the box. What's in the box? Hilarious game. So funny. I don't want Benjeter. I mean, I do want Benjeter, but I don't want Benjeter. Gonna hurt our damage a little bit, but no, we do not want Damocles. Damocles would be a bad idea. Sure. Soul Locket. Yeah, we'll take Incubus here. That was Guppy, by the way, that we passed up. But I have a feeling we're probably going to see another Guppy item. Something tells me, oh my god. Okay. Well, we've got another death certificate. So we can't take another Space Bar item. I don't think if we use death certificate, I don't think we come back to here. I think we go back, which we can't do because we need 9 lives, which would give us Guppy. I really don't think that we're gonna be put back in here. So it comes down to, do I think we're gonna get 9 lives, or do we just use death certificate to get 9 lives? We are not powerful enough to beat Beast right now. I'm gonna actually pass on that. That hurts. Trust me, it hurts. But we're not powerful enough for me to comfortably beat Beast. But we also we need to get 9 lives. We got Guppy, but we need to have more. There's the toys good here. Round of light, speed ball. I'm gonna actually re-roll this. Or should we wait for the Devil Deal to re-roll? We should probably wait for the Devil Deal to re-roll. Spirit Sword. Spirit Sword Mom's Knife is pretty fun. What, Bubby? There it is. Okay, 9 lives is good. Okay. Now we can start thinking about the future here. Monstrance. Lazarus is rags. Duality. E-Twanky. Yeah, this is all pretty bad. Use his freaking shadow. But bombs. Holy Mantidu. I'm an idiot. Serpent's Kiss. Sure. I'm gonna have to take the Razor Blade because it's the only way that we can hurt ourselves. What happens if we use a Razor Blade in Book of Virtues? I actually don't know. Powder. Again, we gonna be here for a while, y'all. Just settle in. Settle in. Heat upgrade. Shot speed. It doesn't matter. Death list here. Cammy Conception. Sure. Humbling Bundada. Dogtooth. I don't think it really matters. Occasional rock bottom. That's fine. Rock bottom. Yeah, we can take a school bag. Tech 2, Tech 1. Gimpy, sure. Yeah, I'll take some Death's List, and yeah, I'll take Host Hat. Dark Prince's Crown, Deadeye again. Eddie. Come on, you know who we're looking for, game. There's only one perfect end to all of this. Might be able to get a teleportation card so we don't actually have to, like, you know, off ourselves at this point. I actually don't want Toxic Show. Oh, yeah, I do. It doesn't matter. That. And, yeah, I'll take you. Oh, I mean, you know. Take Hungry Soul. I guess I'll take you. Hit a play. Get some battery action. A little hushy. Friend Finder, you know we love you. Cracked Orb. Do not want Glitch Crown. Be a nightmare in here. Spewer. Brimstone. I don't think Brimstone does anything with Spirit Sword. Gonna take it anyway. Red Stew with Rock Bottom. Purity, yeah. Sack of Sacks. We won't have, I mean, we basically won't have a Tears down at this point, so. Okay. This is getting, now we're starting to get out of control again here. Quince here. Come on, game. You know who we're looking for. Just give her to us. Just deliver her to us. Deliver her to us. You know that we want to see her. Everyone's waiting for her. Take Skeleton Key. Take Sad Bombs. Come on, game. We haven't seen her. No! Emperor card. The Emperor card, I don't think, teleports us out of the... Well, maybe it does, actually. Strength card, yeah. Okay. All right, well, welcome back, everyone, for those of you who skipped ahead. Oh, we got taken out. Yes! Never mind. We didn't even need it. Okay. Genesis takes you out of there. Good to know. And then we're just a lamb kill away and a beast kill away from ending it. The pact. Again. Yeah, I'll take Maggie's bow. Why not? Oh, boy. Oh, boy. What's giving us? Oh, it's tech. That's why. That's right. It's tech 1 and tech 2 doing that. I was like, we didn't take Jacob's Ladder and we don't have tech 0 anymore, so. Yeah. Absolutely, we're going to do a victory lap on our way to the Omega Run victory dance. Let's just end it. This video is an hour and 39 minutes long, everyone. It's a celebration of the ultimate dream run that we could have possibly ever hoped for. I mean, what can you say? You thought it was going to be just a regular old Tuesday? Uh-uh, we got you covered. We have got you covered. I know we're missing a lot. I know we're skipping a lot. But look, I'm going to take care of my voice and do the right thing. Be smart about it. However, it's good to get an Omega Run under our belts. It's been a very long time since we were able to do one. By the way, if you're not sure what an Omega Run is, Omega Run is literally doing every single boss in the game, including the optional bosses, on one continuous run. So, like, technically this isn't one run because we used Narki, and obviously we had, like, you know, a couple of victory laps thrown into the mix here, but we're talking about one continuous run. Like, one continuous run. That's the best thing I can say. A marathon of a run. This looks like something out of Dead Cells. Seriously. Like, we look like we're swinging the sword, like, that was designed in anime. I kind of love it. I mean, it's instant activation on the sword. It's crazy. Absolutely nuts. I don't know what this does, but sure. Can you get two spirit swords? We're answering a lot of questions today. It appears that you can, I guess. Udo gives us a tears up. Sure. I don't think it's gonna matter because we have Libra. I don't think any of this really matters at the end of the day. If you've ever wanted to see Isaac cry, as in like the game cry for real, yeah, you're seeing it right now. You're crazy if you don't think that I'm not going to do boss rush real quick. Because we getting our boss rush in. We've already done it once, but we're going to do it again. Just to see how ridiculous it can get. It actually is. But we do need to get a teleportation card to get out of there. There's nowhere near here, but, you know, we'll find it eventually. Dogtooth just losing its mind right now. Just see how fast boss rush can go. Oh yeah, we have brimstone too, don't we? Well, let's see. I didn't even swing it, Mom. Boss rush, we got Scorpio, Appel, the D4, which I am not going to do. Sure. Oh yeah, I have a cult as well, as kind of a thing. Surprisingly, not as fast as our first boss rush. That's a huge hungry soul. All right. And let's finish it. Isaac's still spinning, by the way. Here we are in Mausoleum. I forgot to go get my Emperor card. I'm pretty sure it's not going to matter. Oh yeah, we ran into this last time, didn't we? That's right. So, what we have to do here, unfortunately, because the game is not programmed to handle this much awesomeness, is we're currently softlocked. There's no way, even if we got out of here, there's no way to spawn Dad's note. There's literally no way, unless we found another R key, which I'm not going to do at this point. So I'm going to give myself Dad's note so we can continue and finish this run as it should have been. But remember, this is a programming error. This is not the result of mods or anything like that. So I'm going to give myself Dad's note. We can be done with it.
Spent it. It's gone. Just get over it.
It's been so long since we did an Omega run. I forgot that that's a thing.
How can you have spent our savings?
Don't worry about it, Maggie. Don't worry about it. We got crack key. Not that it's going to matter, of course. Yeah, we could go look through all these item rooms, but come on. Come on. I predict that Dogma will die in less than 2 seconds. Phase one. Phase two, Dogma will probably live for 1 second. And Beast will take a grand total of, like, probably 1 minute, if that. Like, I mean, like, from start to finish. Like, all the horsemen, everything. Like, we're going so fast, like, the speech, like, the voice acting is not going to be able to catch up. Yeah. Like I said. I just can't do this anymore. I'm sorry. I wonder if Inner Child will even still be here. We even see it? I guess we didn't. All right, so that is indeed going to be the final part to this hour and 47-minute saga. What a run. What a run. I really wish we didn't have to use the console to give ourselves dad's note. I wish the game just, like, you know, worked. Yeah, that was less than a second there. But what can you do? So thank you for watching, everyone. I hope you enjoyed it. Remember, if you did, make sure you click the like button. Let's time Beastie here. 147.21 is when we started. And thank you again, everyone, for the support. Let's get the like streak back on target. This is just not even fair. There's war. All right, well, that took a grand total of 29 seconds. And... all right, it was almost a minute. So thank you for watching, everyone. Again, Omega Run complete. Thank you for liking, commenting, subscribing, everyone. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Flashback 007, Austin Wilkinson, Spartan Duncan, Garbage, Kylie Nupp, and Bummium. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find by going to patreon.com/Sinvicta.